Motion charts plot your data in five dimensions. You select the metrics to be represented on the X and Y axis, and you select the metrics to be represented by the color and size of the dots. Let's click Visualize from the Keyword Report. Each dot is a keyword. This keyword had 15 visits, with an average of 9 pages viewed per visit. This keyword had 5 visits, with an average of 15 pages viewed per visit. Now, let's make the size of the dots correspond to the keyword conversion rate. All but 2 of the keywords disappear because their conversion rates are so low. This keyword had a conversion rate of 0.17%. This keyword brought in fewer visits and has fewer pages viewed per visit, but it's a little bigger with a conversion rate of 0.25%. For each of these keywords, what percentage of the visits are new visits? Let's change the color to indicate this. Both are red now, so they were all 100% new visits. Let's drag the slider back and see how all these variables changed over time. We start on July 12th. At that time, this keyword had the biggest conversion rate of all of them, but it just had 1 visit. This keyword had 11 visits and 11 pages viewed per visit. It's orange, so it had a high percentage of new visits, but not quite 100% like all the red ones. Let's drag the slider forward and see what happens. Here, the conversion rate is the same. It's getting fewer visits with more pages viewed per visit. Here, its conversion rate has decreased slightly. It's getting fewer visits, and average pages viewed per visit has increased. It's completely red, so all visits are coming from new visitors. As time goes on, that keyword disappears entirely. It's not getting any conversions. Pressing play, we can see that the number of keywords that get conversions changes. At the end of the time frame, only 2 keywords get conversions. Let's use the Trails feature to isolate the patterns for another keyword. We'll drag the slider back to the beginning. We can now see a history of how this keyword has performed over the time period. We can see the range of values for each of our 4 metrics. And we can mouse over each data point to see the metrics. Using the Link to Chart feature, we can even get a link that will load this motion chart later on. You're now ready to try out motion charts with your own data. Thanks for listening.